Have you ever wondered how to get a similar style throughout your images in Midjourney?
Well, today I'm going to show you one of the newest features, that is moodboards. Basically, what moodboards do is allow you to bring the reference photos that you want for a specific moodboard or style, and then just apply it over all your creations in Midjourney. Similar to styles, you can control how much the intensity of the mood board is applied to your prompts, but the difference is that it's a bit more organized than with the style reference. This is the homepage of Midjourney, and you just go to personalize, and here we have the option to create a mood board. So we just click here, and how do we start? You can add your own photos or other images that you have created before in Midjourney. Okay, so I'm going to show you one of the mood boards that I created a while ago, that is the film camera one, and it's right over here. So for this mood board, I just added a bunch of my travel photos from my film camera. That's why that's the name of the mood board. And if you see, it's a very lo-fi style, like really with a few light leaks and not such like high quality, but still you get some grainy look, right? So that's pretty great. And I just added the photos here, and that's how I created the mood board. You can also change the name, and if you want, you could create a mood board from your own images from your gallery. Here on add from gallery, you can just select different images, but in this time we're just going to leave it like that, and I'm going to show you how to use it. So we're just going to go to create. We're going to type a woman walking down the street of New York. For adding the mood board, we just go over here to the settings, and we are going to select and personalize the film camera one. But beware, you can have several mood boards select at the same time, so sometimes you just type in whatever prompt and select the mood board and you have like several selected. That has happened to me, so just be sure that only one of your mood boards is selected. We're just gonna have the film camera one on. I like to use it in RAW and 16:9 radio. The stylization is what it's going to serve us as the intensity of what the mood board is applied into our prompt. For example, if I want to have it like the standard, I will leave it at 100, but if I want it to be super intense, I will apply it in 1000. So we're just going to leave it in 100 now to see the standard version, and click enter. You can also get the code of this mood board by clicking on it, and you will get it as a profile instead of an SRF code. Okay, so we're starting to have some images. Let's see what happens. So yay, here we go. As you see, it's a bit lo-fi, low quality, like in the moment style, a bit of cricket angles. And yeah, it does really do a good job. So I'm just gonna do a retest with the same prompt, but I am going to go to 1000 of a slice and see what happens. Let's just go up and see what it comes out. So what's really cool about moodboards is that it's way more organized than SRFs, and you can still use the SRFs if you like it more. I just think it's really cool that now you can create your own moodboards and share it with your friends or your other internet people that you meet here. Okay, so we're starting to see the results. It is a bit more grainy, I believe, a bit more applied. So as you can see, the difference between these, I believe it's mostly in the texture and on the intensity of the face of the people. So these two are very different, but they have this like in the moment look to it. So that will be all for today. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a great day. Oh, I forgot to say, my name is Gabriela, and if you like this video, please subscribe, and don't forget to click the like button. Okay, bye.